An archive of knowledge.
No sign of the Light Elves.
For now.
Maybe they've left for the day, and we can browse at our leisure. So, these are the Valiant schematics, eh?
You know of him.
Huh? Aye. One of the most gifted dwarven smiths around. Until he developed a conscience, anyhow.
These runes. Texts alone are not enough to end the Elven War, but restricting their access only serves those who wish to prolong it.
Taking a page out of Odin's book.
Aye, quite the advantage for the Light Elves.
Sealed, but there is an inscription. The console.
Bigvir spoke of an exile of the same name. Odds are he'd like a gander at that particular text.
All this knowledge of their ancestors, their shared history, poetry.
Ah, it appears the librarian would like a word.
Lata Framborg.
Sounds like she wants that journal back.
No.
Shield strike!
Go!
Hiding all this knowledge away.
Our ally wishes to read this journal. We are taking the book.
I'm impressed. Thought you were going to end her.
When last we traveled here, after Faye passed, I killed an elf of great importance. The ramifications were dire for his people. I do not wish to make the same mistake twice.
A lady. I was curious about some of the flora we've encountered on our travels.
And you will remain curious. It's not my job to teach you everything, Mimir.
Look, I was just asking.
And you have been told.
Well, you can say that again.
Speaking of your brother after he was burned by the Aesir mob.
Yes. It haunted him for a long time. It doesn't excuse what he said at my wedding, but I do understand where his anger came from. I hope Freyr will appreciate our work here in the desert. I wonder if he knows how poorly this realm has fared in his absence.
Aye. Hearing the Song of the Sands again is a rare privilege, even if it's only a solo act.
Or a duet, once this Hofgufa is free. This architecture, it is not of the Dark Elves.
An abandoned ancient settlement, by the looks of it. Built long before the Lightwell's creation.
More hive there as well.
I'd say we're on the right track then.
What kind of hive material is sensitive to sound? How odd.
Thank you.
When I last came here with you and Atreus, I assumed the absence of Alfheim's light was an aberration. I didn't realize it was covered by hive matter.
Aye. And as far as the Dark Elves are concerned, it's that light column in the center of the temple that's the aberration. Just look at how old some of these surfaces are. Far older than the Lightwell, or even our trap half-tipper for that matter.
That's quite the empathetic perspective, Mimir.
Well, dangle from a burly god's backside for a few winters, and you'll find yourself looking for all sorts of new perspectives.
More hives, but denser. Too thick for that. Maybe the Twilight Stone on the ground will help. There you go.
Wretch on the left! Cover! The wee bastard's about to explode!
Enemy, behind you!
Behind you! Look out!
Enemies to your left!
What for?
Incoming poison up above! travel underneath the Barrens, do they?
Territory changes hands often in Alfheim, or so it appears.
Bigvir did mention that these ruins have historical significance for the Light Elves. I assume they're only here to keep intruders out.
Well, at least they tried.
I suspect the corpse below would disagree.
Look there. That hive doesn't like sound, remember?
Good eye. Let's continue, shall we?
Goofers will allow them to breed again. It was a dazzling display once. The skies of Alfheim filled with their song.
I imagine it's the lack of fresh light that's caused this pair to grow abnormally large. No use in having babies if there's nothing for them to feed on.
Trying to protect their children from a harsh world. I can relate.
Yeah!
I wonder if these two comprehend the choice they face means free.
What choice do you speak of?
The life cycle of the Hofgufa. In order to breed, they must pass on their light to their children.
And without light, they will die.
I suppose that's all any of us can hope for in the end. That our death has purpose. That we can live on through our children. Well, given another chance, I know what choice I would take. There's some Twilight Stone. Almost there.
Back to the surface, then.
Mind you, watch!
Used in many of Freyr's blessings, I imagine.
The fate of these creatures. It reminds me of a story.
Does it?
There once was a blacksmith whose king commanded him to construct a box that could contain all the evils of the world. But no metal could hold such power. So the blacksmith used the flame
of... Kratos, is this a story meant to ease my grief?
Perhaps it is just a story. A way to pass the time.
I appreciate the sentiment, but... Well, your stories...
What about my stories?
I wouldn't exactly call them a comfort.
Fair. Mimir is the better storyteller.
Now don't sell yourself short, brother. You've come a long way from the days of laconic fables.
It's okay. Finish your story, Kratos.
The blacksmith's daughter was the key to unlocking the box. He died trying to protect her from those who were real.
Well, at least it's a relatable story.
Appears we've overstayed our welcome in Alfheim. Yet again.
Take solace in knowing you did what you thought was best for your son's safety. Even these creatures know there is little choice for a parent. You are not alone.
I'm not, am I? And now neither are they. Incredible.
Song of the Sands.
Well, didn't know I could get misty. It's beautiful.
Thank you, Kratos. This land sings once more. We've done good here.
No rush to leave yet, is there? Who knows what kind of adventures await us in a freshly lit barrens?